like I have a lot of meaning behind them, and some of them are just what I was feeling at, in that moment. And if my work hits someone with a whole new meaning or a whole new way of feeling about something, I'd be happy with that. And that's mainly why I don't have meanings behind my work. I always like pretending I am someone watching over my work and not actually the artist in an exhibit. And I always ask the people, what do they think behind it? What do they like? What do they think the artist wanted? If they ask me who I am, and I will tell them who I am, because my name will be there. But I prefer it that way, because then you hear the honest truth if they don't know you're the artist. In primary school, we never did art. But in the last year, in year six, we had an artist come in and he did a bit of art with us. Intrigued me, and in secondary school, I liked it and I saw the progress behind it. Ended up joining the art club. Got really into it, and I liked the fact that you could be different and like creating things was so much fun. But it wasn't until I actually met my friends who did art, and I helped them out with their work, and they helped me out, and we kind of grew together. If they didn't push me, if they didn't show me I was good, I don't think I would have carried on. Being an artist, it's easy in the concept of doing your own work. It's because all you have to do is just spray paint onto a wall, or you could draw a stick man, or you could do swirls. As long as you're expressing yourself and you're putting how you feel, how you see things onto a piece of paper, it doesn't matter if it's perfect, but it's also hard to get your name out there, to find your own style, to even promote it across everyone. It's one of the hardest things you can do, but if you love it enough, you'll keep doing it.